I'm Hoki. When I was in the fourth grade and it was clear that I had more challenges than my peers when it came to certain types of learning, my parents insisted that my public school provide neuropsych testing. When my school came back with results saying that I just had behavioral issues, my parents took me to get a second opinion. When the school didn't honor that opinion, they then didn't provide the services they were required to, my parents placed me in a private school for kids with LD. Unfortunately, for too many students with LD issues like me, this is not how the story goes. This is where the importance of SMARTS come in. Stuck in schools that either cannot or will not provide the services my parents were able to give me, students end up falling through the cracks and into two predictable outcomes. By the time I signed up as a mentor for the original iteration of the SMARTS program, I had just completed neuropsych testing at the ILD facility in Lexington and was in my last year at the Carroll School. For those of you who don't know, Carroll is a school specifically for LD students, so every day is a SMARTS class. By the time I signed on as a, come the inaugural meeting of SMARTS community, I had a lot of the academic skills the program teaches. My mentee, on the other hand, did not. Stuck in the doldrums of elementary school, she was floundering in a system built not to help her succeed, but to let her fail. I cannot promise that I was the perfect mentor, or that the mentoring experience was always smooth sailing. It took more work on my part than I thought it would. Every week, when we did check-ins on the phone, via email, over ice cream, I saw a young girl struggling much the same way I had. How was I, a 14-year-old dealing with her own insecurities, supposed to help this girl? For 5 years, SMARTS gave both of us an assist. It gave me a chance to learn to mentor and gain confidence in my voice. It gave Alexa, my mentee, a place to be celebrated for her differences rather than marginalized or cast aside. We were part of SMARTS because our brains work differently. Not just anyone can be part of the SMARTS Club. When we were at SMARTS, neurotypical took on a whole new meaning. At monthly SMARTS meetings, it was okay not to spell a word correctly while brainstorming for one of our projects. No one cared. Taking a while to read through the written instructions? That's okay. So was everyone else. Yes, SMART provides truly valuable academic support, but it also teaches kids like me, kids like Alexa, and kids like our mentees, that it's okay to learn differently. It taught us that we were not the only space cadets in the room, as Chase will so aptly describe later. It taught us and continues to teach students throughout the country that having a learning difference isn't bad, it's just different. This is something that I've carried with me throughout the rest of my academic and now early professional life. After graduating high school and leaving SMARTS, I ended up a history major and then a public policy master's student. SMARTS taught me that there is no shame in advocating for myself and for my learning disabilities. That to succeed as a student was well within my rights just as much as the next non-LD student. I never thought 10 years ago when I started SMARTS as an 8th grader that I would voluntarily read hundreds of pages a week and then crank out 10, 20, 30-page papers. I never thought that I would be the point person to edit client deliverables at work, with the caveat that you don't do spelling. However, I rarely had any doubt that the way my brain worked would preclude me from getting where I wanted to go. And for this, in part, I must give SMART its due. So on behalf of all the kids whose brains work a little, or maybe a lot, differently, thank you all for being here, and thank you for your continued support.